Did you know there's a tax loophole that could save you tons of money on your taxes if you are a Bitcoin holder? This actually paves the way for something called tax loss harvesting. So the government wants to tax you, but they only want to tax you on the money you actually make. In order to support businesses and people that are taking risks, they don't want to punish you if you were to lose money. So what happens when you lose money? The amount of money you lose will not be taxable. Generally speaking. Now, what happens if you were to invest in Bitcoin, let's say at $40,000, and it were to drop to $20,000, and you were to sell your Bitcoin? Essentially, what happened is that you took a $20,000 loss, and now the IRS will not want to penalize you or tax you on that $20,000. If you are holding a stock or a security, you cannot take a loss and then buy it right back. And then say, oh, I lost a bunch of money, because you actually still own the same amount of shares. That wouldn't make sense for the IRS to let you do that. But because cryptocurrency is a new thing, it hasn't been classified as a security, at least not up till come maybe January 1st, when a new bill is to pass and it's going to probably reclassify cryptocurrency as security, because right now it's listed as some kind of real estate, which I don't think is totally inaccurate, but I understand that they want to treat it more like a security because it's being traded and invested in like stocks and securities. So this does not apply, let's say, just because the fact that your Bitcoin has dropped. You actually have to sell it to realize this loss. The reason why this loophole is so powerful is because the wash sale rule doesn't apply. So anytime your cryptocurrency dips, hypothetically, you could sell, take a loss, and then minus that from your taxable income. And the magic of this rule is that I could sell my Bitcoin at $30,000, but I could also immediately buy it back. So I'm still holding the same amount of Bitcoin. If I was bullish on Bitcoin, I would hold it anyways. But now essentially my total payable taxes has just been slashed by a significant amount. And this applies to all of your cryptocurrency. So if you are taking a big loss now, technically speaking, you could just sell all of your cryptocurrencies and just take a huge loss, but then immediately buy it back. And you would have the same amount of crypto and just a reduced tax liability. Now, there are some caveats to this. Number one, you have to keep very, very good records. You have to know exactly when you bought your cryptocurrency, what exactly you sold it for. And for most people that earn cryptocurrency, it moves so fast. You have so many different types of cryptocurrency. It's just hard to keep track of. And if the IRS comes knocking, you better have really good records to justify why you are taking all of these taxes off the table this year. The second thing is that when you do something like tax loss harvesting, when you sell your Bitcoin and you want to buy it back, Bitcoin is actually very, very volatile. So you could sell it for, let's say, $42,000, but then you try to buy it back for $42,000 and suddenly it's at $45,000 or it's at $50,000. Or more likely than not, you get a little bit greedy and you want to buy it for cheaper and you're just waiting for it to go cheaper, but it never goes cheaper again. So you have to be disciplined and decide basically that if you want to do tax loss harvesting, that you're not going to get greedy, that you're going to sell and immediately buy it back as quickly as you can. The advantages of doing this are obvious. You save a lot of money. But the disadvantages are that it adds complexity to your taxes, a lot more complexity. And you need to know how to navigate it. And you also need to know how to execute this. But if you want to save a ton of money, if you have significant stake in crypto and your portfolio looks down, there is no reason not to do this, especially if you have the assistance of a qualified accountant or some kind of financial advisor that could help guide you through this to make sure you are doing this legally. That's really all I wanted to share with you today. I know it's been a while, but thank you for sticking with me. I will have probably a lot more crypto-related content coming soon, especially since I've been really, really deep into mining. And that's something I really want to share with you guys because it's been really fun, a lot of learning. Please stay tuned and thank you for watching.